Hey guys, what's up? It's Kenji, and we're going to jump right into this. This is macaroni and cheese. All right. So, I got some pepper jack cheese. I got some some Monterey Jack cheese. And I got some sharp cheddar cheese. Right now, what I'm making is the base for the macaroni and cheese. This is butter. I'm gonna let that just melt down. I'm gonna give you a peek in the oven, because I already got one in there. Can you guys see that? Don't you want some? Okay, so we're gonna let this butter melt down just like that. And to this, we're gonna add some flour. Add the flour. And give it a good stir. That's actually perfect because I've already had some cream sauce, and I don't want it to get any thicker than what it is. This is just a 3-cheese macaroni. I usually use 6. I do use half and half or a heavy whipping cream. I'm gonna put that in there like that. And the trick to this, so you don't lump up, is to keep stirring it. And if you got it to the right consistency, it will thicken up just a bit. You can see how in the corners there, it's starting to thicken up for me. This is like really, really simple. Anybody can do this. This actually is a request from one of my viewers on YouTube. Actually asked me if I would make some macaroni and cheese, so here it is. My friend Tree, who's on my cooking group on Vloggerheads, did a real easy flan today. And I was like so impressed by it, and I'm actually, when I first started cooking, was very intimidated by the kitchen. But once I started jumping in and just doing it and getting involved, it's super, super easy, and there's nothing to be intimidated about. I'm gonna add a little bit of more of this half and half to this. Give it another quick stir. Turn it off the heat. Over here I have my macaroni, and we're just gonna pour this over the mac and cheese. And I'm losing my battery, so I'm gonna work a lot faster. This we're gonna mix around. You just wanna mix it to where everything is all mixed and coated. And yummy, yummy goodness. Then to this, I'm gonna dump my cheeses. Dump my cheeses. Again, you want to mix it around really good. Make sure all this gets mixed in. Make sure every piece of the mac shells has cream and the cheese on it. And it's actually okay if you want to thin this out a bit. to add a little bit more cream to it to thin it out, because it is going to bake and it is going to heat up, so it's going to thicken up a little bit more. Then I am going to add my last cheese. I have some more sharp cheddar grated. And like I said, you can add more cream to this to kind of thin it out a little bit, and I'm going to do that. I just wanted to give you a quick look at this. This is how I put it together, and this is what it's going to look like when it comes out of the oven. And basically all it is it's the macaroni and cheese, it's already fully cooked. Basically what you're doing is just letting that brown. This is so good, guys. Actually, I'll give you a taste of what's in the pan. Baby, when that cooks. So this is my last outreach. I'll be able to feed 40 people with my, I have 3 pans of macaroni and cheese, and I'm gonna do a turkey tenderloin, and it's another one of my signature sandwiches. It is the turkey tenderloin chicken salad mac and cheese sandwich. Peace and blessings, guys. Thanks for watching. I hope this helps my YouTube fan for who wanted the macaroni and cheese. Guys, no more blue box. Cut it out.